What's good, superstars? On this week's news, Nigerians react as Twitter chooses Ghana as the regional hub of Africa. CBN refutes claims of printing currency to tackle economic challenges. Nigerian army to engage retirees as insecurity becomes a national concern. And Canada rejects request of asylum seeker who was part of the special anti-robbery squad in Nigeria. Welcome to another sizzling episode of The Scoop here on OSG TV. My name is Blessings, and as you know, I am bringing you the hottest news recap. So let's get into it. Let's talk about how Jack Dorsey, the CEO of Twitter, shanked Niger this week and chose Ghana as the regional hub of Africa. A lot of people are wondering, what happened? Like, why is that? Twitter was literally buzzing over this news. Now, the president of Ghana, Nana Akufo-Addo, said that was excellent news, but obviously some Nigerians did not agree with him. I mean, the difference is kind of clear. Now, according to statistics, Nigeria has over 39 million users of Twitter alone, and that is more than the entire 32 million population of Ghana. And this even brought back the infamous Jollof Wars between both countries. But here's what Twitter has to say about Ghana. Ghana is an advocate for democracy, is also a supporter of freedom of speech and a supporter of online freedom. So why not, if not? And you know, congratulations to Ghana. Nigeria, catch yourself. Now, for some reason, the Edo State Governor, Godwin Obaseki, recently started talking about the economic recession in the country. Now, speaking at a meeting, he said that Nigeria is so broke that recently CBN had to print over 60 billion naira to share within the three tiers of government in March. Now, he also said that Nigeria has a very strange presidential system where the government goes to sleep, wakes up, goes to Abuja, prints a lot of money, and then shares within the state, local, and federal government instead of depending on taxes generated from the citizens, which is not supposed to be so. However, CBN has come out to refute the claim, saying that such an amount of money was never printed, and that although Nigeria is struggling economically, they are trying their best to make up for it. Now, in the comment section, we had two different opinions as usual. Some people said if it's true, then it's not the right thing to do, but some other people felt like it's absolutely normal, seeing how coronavirus has affected the economy globally, and then even America got its relief fund from that. So what are we saying? So the Chief of Army Staff, General Ibrahim Atairu, made an announcement recently that the services of retired military men will be needed to tackle the insecurity challenges facing the country. Now, this is coming after a lot of attacks on the military from terrorists. I mean, recently there was a missing fighter jet, and then a lot of soldiers have been killed in recent times and have been buried. And so he is saying that these retirees still have a lot more to offer instead of sitting around when the country is faced with such level of insecurity challenges. Now, this sounded quite funny to some people, but quite valid to a lot of other people. Some people felt it's only in Nigeria you see such. But then, you know, according to reports, these retired men will not be needed on the field per se, but will be needed in every other area where they can function. So good luck to them. Canada has rejected the request of one Olusola Popola, who is seeking asylum into the country, reasons being that he was a member of the Special Anti-Robbery Squad in Nigeria. That is the SARS. Now, according to Canada, they cannot grant him asylum. Olusola was a member of SARS from 2002 to 2015, but according to him, he tried to resign in 2011 but was not permitted, and so he had to wait till 2015. So now, he is approaching the Federal Court of Canada to seek inadmissibility, seeing how he's not at fault in all of this. And more credit to the ENSAS protest, it seems to be getting a lot of global recognition, and so much results is stemming from it so far. Well, that's all I got for you today on The Scoop. Don't forget, for more of these, you can link us up on our website at www.olorisupergirl.com and our Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook handles at olorisupergirl. And for your ad replacements, don't forget, you can send a direct message to hello@olorisupergirl.com and you will definitely get a response. My name is Blessings, and if you want more of this, I'll give you more of this next week right here on The Scoop. Bye.